see trees of green.
What is the best part so far of being 87 years old?
The best part?
Yeah.
Is that I'm not 90.
Okay, I guess that was a relief. Yes. What else? What do you think that has been great in the past 86 years?
Highlights.
Having you guys in my life. So much of it was so good. Not much was bad. But it's hard to tell me what the best part, I mean, for me to figure out what the best part was.
What's the chapter titles, if it were a book?
I see trees of green, red roses too.
And I fall asleep in her lap, waiting for the storm to be over. It was either a hurricane or just a bad, bad thunderstorm or something. Usually it was a hurricane or one nearby or something, and they changed their directions at the last minute. So. We lived in a trailer, so, yeah. And unless the trailer, you always have to head it into the storm. Well, when you get to a new place, you can't always do that because you don't know which direction the storm is going to come from.
We have a special sound.
Kind of unpredictable anyway. So we just plan on sitting there. She'd always go up to the desk and ask him if it'd be all right. She'd tell him we live in a trailer. We can't move it now. Florida. Yeah. Usually in the northwestern part, or no, the eastern side. But not always. Trailers were an oddity then. Trailers weren't around very long in the early 30s, which is where I'm going to talk about. And my dad had a, I don't know what kind of car it was, but he smoked and he dropped a cigarette down in the seat, burned up all the upholstery, and after that we sat on the frame of the seats with no upholstery on it. And wooden crates, like tomato crates. And he put them on the wires of what remained of this, what was a seat, to build us up higher, especially for the driver. And we were an oddity when we were just a car pulling a trailer. And then he got a second trailer that the first trailer pulled. So we were a car, a trailer, and another trailer. Because he had to have a shop where he could make neon. There were no jobs available anywhere. So he made neon, and he'd go to different stores and he'd show them what he could do. And they'd buy socks for him. He's a good salesman. And he had his gas jet in his workshop, which was the one trailer, and he lived in the other trailer. He was afraid because I was ready to walk. And meanwhile, I'm crawling around on my hands and knees. And although he swept up every 30 minutes almost, he couldn't be sure if the boom caught all the little fragments of glass. And there were always pieces of glass. So he thought, how could he keep me off the floor? I was crawling pretty much. I wasn't walking very well. And I sat on one of his transformers, which it was a perfect height for a stool for me. I thought it was for me to sit on. electricity from that transformer to light his piece of sign he just made. And he told me, but fortunately, it takes a while for electricity to travel. And by the time he saw me, he ran over to it and he kicked me as hard as he could. And I went flying on that transformer. And I was so mad at him for kicking me like that.
How old were you?
Probably two.
Do you remember that?
I don't remember any of it. How would I remember it?
You're telling the story.
Because you told me about it.
Okay.
I didn't make it up.
Yeah.
I experienced it, but I don't remember it.
Yeah. So he kicked you to get you off the transformer.
He kicked me so hard that I went flying off the it was about that high.
Yeah.
It didn't prevent you from being electrocuted. No. Okay.
So I almost got the electric chair.
Really?
Yeah. Electric stools.
You saved my life. Partly responsible for my being in that danger in the first place.
Yeah, I think that is the missing piece, the hazardous play environment. Not conditions that we accept today.
She wrote 87 real big and with an exclamation mark.
Yeah.
So I don't forget.
It's an important age.
Well, it certainly was a special day. So sweet. Safdia, Yumi, Grizzly.
That's
the cat. Gordon. I forget which one is Gordon. Ralph. And Carl. Who's Ralph and Carl?
Also cats.
Other cats.
There are cats.
How many cats do you have?
No cats.
Zofnia, you. Oh, Yumi's a dog. Grizzly. They're all cats but Yumi, right?
And Safdia.
And Safdia. What?
It's just funny.
Aww.
Funny amount of attention. To yeah. Who's Carl and Ralph?
Wait.
What? He said, who's Carl and Ralph? And that's funny to us, because they're our cats that we love.
Yeah. Well, you can't tell by their names. Aww.
The gift that... Here's the gift. I'm turning back.
Wow. They're batteries for what? Watches?
No.
No? I don't know what to do. My watches are all
stuck.
I don't know what to put in there. Is that a garter?
Or what? No.
What is it?
One garter and some wash Keep going. Open the other part
well,
of it.
Well, it looks like a suspender, but it's too little.
Yes. It'd be a suspender for a very small human. microscope. I'm gonna put you.
What is that?
Well, open the other part of the present and we'll all make sense of it.
Oh, and then I'll know. Well, I already did.
No.
Those are batteries.
Yep. There's one more thing in there.
Well.
No, in the bag, Grandma. In the brown bag. In the gift bag. Okay,
this has to go with this?
Yes, and all three items go together. Okay.
How did you know I wanted one of those?
I'm a good listener.
I told you?
I'm a good listener, yeah.
I don't remember you even being with me when I was talking about that. Pedometer.
Yeah. That's exciting.
Oh, I know. Well, I used to have one years and years ago. And I don't know whatever happened. It went like some things do sometimes.
Here, we'll put it together. Open your next gift.
Oh, I'm excited about that. Because I walk, and I have no idea how far I'm walking. Uh-huh. And I've been walking around the building. I have a little path, you know, that goes around the halls. And, uh-huh. And so I did that once, and it was a good little walk. And I thought, I'll try it twice. So I got up twice, and now I'm ready to go to three times around. But I want to know how far it is.
Yeah.
So I don't want to overdo it or do it too fast. And I wasn't sure quite how to break it down either. Oh, thank you. But what are these batteries for?
The pedometer.
For the...
Pedometer.
Pedometer, yeah. I couldn't even remember how to say it. Yeah, it's been years since I had one. But I wore it every day when I had it. I think it just stopped working for some reason, or it was a bad battery or something. I don't know what happened, but couldn't get it to work anymore. This thing weighs a ton.
It does.
Is it just a... It's a book. Oh, I was going to say, it feels like a... bunch of lead or something in a box.
That would be a good book.
It must weigh 10 pounds. I'm serious. You didn't believe me. Sanjay Garson. Oh, I wanted this book. And I just ran across this recently. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know he had it out. It's just been released recently.
Mm-hmm.
And he has a magazine now coming out that's going to be monthly.
Mm-hmm.
Do you watch the show?
Hmm?
Do you watch the show?
I haven't lately. I have seen it.
I've never seen it.
Oh, my goodness. This was expensive, too. But, oh, I'll be calling you every day, giving you information from Dr. Dr. Oz. Oh, he's one of my favorite people. Oh my.
Have you ever seen the show?
I used to watch it again. Uh-huh. He used to be a special guest at Oprah, so I'd come home from school and we'd watch it.
Okay. Why are you whispering?
I'm just talking to him, so I'm not talking loud.
Yeah, but I can't make out what you're saying.
I told him that he used to be a special guest on Oprah, and then he got his own show.
Yeah. Yeah. He's amazing.
This is from Tammy and Keel. Oh.
Aunt Tammy and who?
Uncle Keel.
Uncle Keel. I thought you said Jim. It sounded like it. This is from my...
Look at the front.
What is this?
There's a thing on the front for you to read. Flip it back. Flip it back to the front.
Where is it? How do you know which?
And there's
is
a piece
front?
Of paper stuck, and you can read that.
Well, Keel and Tammy. What is it?
You need a knife?
It's a puzzle.
Yeah, it's a puzzle to stimulate your brain.
To what?
To stimulate your brain. It's a puzzle specifically for memory assistance.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I do a lot of the things that they suggest for, it's supposed to be equivalent to exercise to a physical thing, and because this is mental, you know, it's like, well, for example, crossword puzzles were supposed to be very good. It didn't mention that in this particular list I'm referring to, but it's like that. It's kind of like that.
I think she has scissors in the kitchen. Knife might be a little tricky. He's going to get scissors.
I'm just going to use one.
You can use your knife.
Aqua paint canvases, reusable. Interesting.
So it's another activity that's supposed to help with your brain.
Yeah, I think that's incredible that they come out with stuff like that. And some things that you might not have ever thought about that you do anyway, but not enough to be that helpful. And if you do more of that, if you know what to do more of, it's easier to do it. Transport painting with water. Paint. I'm surprised you didn't see the fish. I don't know how you could be here this long and not see the fish.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.